Hello everyone, today we're going to do a reaction to Jamie Oliver. I think the only other reaction video I've done with him was a reaction to a reaction of Jamie Oliver.
Perfume from the garlic.
I agree with that. Okay.
Now, I didn't choose any of his videos that may be clickbaity, like Jamie Oliver can't cook Indian food. No, I just went with a recent posting of his, Veggie Pasties. Because, one, we've all seen him cook Indian food poorly. And two, let's see, maybe this is something that he does well. Because, I mean, there is a reason that he has almost 6 million subscribers on YouTube. There is a reason that he has had many successful restaurants. There is a reason that he's a number one selling cookbook author. There is a reason he's had TV shows. But I definitely think, though, what you have with Jamie Oliver, you put him in a box. And he's a great in that environment of stuff that he knows and he's comfortable with and that he was trained in. And when you let his creativity go outside of that box, sometimes he can fuck it all up. And I'm hoping we're in his box, in his wheelhouse, but it'll be just as entertaining if he makes a mess out of everything. So I'm gonna click play and let's find out what's going on.
I really wanna share something very classic, very British with you guys, and I wanna go big on mushrooms.
Okay, I know, 5 seconds in, I'm cutting them off, but classic and British. I think this is gonna be in his wheelhouse. So if he mucks this up, I will be surprised.
And that is with the great pasty. I may be swapping out the steak, but with clever cooking, we can get hearty vibes guaranteed. So I've got 500 grams of mushrooms here. We've got the shiitake mushroom, beautiful flavor, lots of vitamin D. We've got the oyster mushroom. You've got the nice chanterelle. Gorgeous flavor, really delicate. And then here, we've got the king oyster. Look at that fella, absolutely brilliant. So by getting a variety of mushrooms, you're gonna get a variety of flavor. And by crushing, tearing, you're gonna get different textures. And then the—
Okay, so from what I've gathered, he's replacing the beef in this with mushrooms to make a vegetarian version. That's perfectly acceptable. For me, I find that the most meatiest tasting mushroom though is the portobello. So by choosing these, I don't think he's going to quite get the most meatiest flavor out of this, but let's see. So yeah, I would have used portobellos and creminis in this mix.
The next process transforms it again. Mushrooms are largely water, so we're going to over-season, right? And when you leave it for like half an hour, that transforms the texture. Let the salt pull the moisture from the mushrooms and get going on some super crumbly short crust pastry.
And that's just like, that technique's borrowed from eggplants. Eggplants have a lot of water too. So what you'll do with eggplants is you'll slice them, put them on a cooling rack, sit it on top of a baking sheet, and salt them. And they will start dripping through that cooling rack. Use a cooling rack so they don't sit in a puddle of their own water. And then you use a baking sheet underneath for collection. I'm going to assume he's going to end up with a puddle of water at the end of that bottom of that bowl. And unlike eggplant water, which really has no use, that mushroom water should have flavor. And you can use it for things like putting it into stocks if you're making it. Or if he's making a pastry, a dough is going to need water. As a kicking this up a notch already, you could pour some of that mushroom water into your dough. I don't know if that'd be good or bad. I'm assuming it'd be great, though. I'm assuming it would just be adding another dimension and layering flavors. Hey, I hate to interrupt the video, but if you're getting any value out of this, could you please hit that subscribe button and leave a comment down below?
It's very, very simple. The old classic recipe of half fat to flour. So 500 grams of strong flour. I'm gonna make a well in the middle, season it with a little salt, and then we're gonna use 250 grams of good quality butter. Just chop it up into little dice. Just keep moving it. Really rub your thumb and your four fingers together. And after about 2 minutes, you'll see it just kind of going into a nice yellow flour. Add 200 mils of cold water, knead gently into a ball, then wrap and chill for an hour.
Right, it's important to rest your doughs to allow the gluten to relax. Even though you're only kneading it for 2 minutes, you are forming gluten, and it does need to relax before you do anything. And you definitely want to heed his advice and cut your butter up small like that, because as the butter as the butter melts and releases steam, that's what punches in those flaky holes in your pastries that gives you a lighter crust. If you don't do it like that, it'll be much denser.
Now for the filling. Peel and chop 200 grams of Swede, one onion, and 400 grams of potatoes.
The filling is going to cook at exactly the same time as the pastry. So therefore, pound coin thickness is our guide and mouth-sized pieces.
Generously season with pepper, plus a pinch of dried rosemary, and make way for our mighty mushrooms.
Grab a little handful like this and just squeeze it. And that is where most of that salt will go. But it's done its job. It's developed flavor, but most importantly, completely different texture. It's gonna be incredible.
Yeah, and that's a good way to get it. Because if you didn't do that, all that water is going to come out during the cooking and you can end up with a soggy mess.
Mix with the rest of the root veg and your filling is done.
Now we can roll out the pastry.
Divide the dough into 8 portions, then roll into roughly 20 centimeter rounds.
They're never perfect, and I kind of like that. So the imperfect is perfect.
Place the veggies on one half, leaving a gap at the edge, then brush with sticky egg wash and fold over.
And what I like to do is take your pastry to the edge, simply push it over and thumb it. Then take it over and thumb it. It really is not technical at all. The egg wash will just finish it. It will go so golden and a little bit shiny. Beautiful.
This recipe makes 8 delicious pasties, so I'll pop 4 in the freezer and save them for a rainy day. And cook the rest now for 40 minutes at 180 degrees Celsius, which is 350 Fahrenheit.
So let's have a look. Oh, that, my friends, is beautiful. It smells amazing. Just let them cool down for a little bit. And in that time, we're gonna make a really delicious salad to have with it. If you think about the panda pitta, those different spikes of chutneys and
those look good, and I don't see anything wrong with this. I think part of the flack that he catches when he does other videos is he'll say the name of a dish. Like, I think he did a biryani video. Or no, it was butter chicken. I think he did a butter chicken video. But he made his butter chicken, and it was like, ah, that looks like a good dish, but that's not butter chicken. So I feel like by using more of a generic name like veggie pasties, I think he's definitely not going to catch any flack for this because they look good and he's not breaking any rules and stepping on anyone's toes.
Some flavors. We can do that too. So red wine vinegar, good extra virgin olive oil, and a little salt and pepper, and then a nice crunchy green apple, a nice sweet red apple.
Slice into matchsticks and dress, along with a good bunch of watercress.
The simplest salad in the world, but utterly delicious.
Serve a wodge with your gorgeous golden pasty.
Then hit it up with an absolute splotch of English mustard. Come on. Rip it open. Oh, yes. Hot and steamy. And if you look into this, you know, you can see the amazing flaky pastry. You can see how the veggies have absolutely cooked into each other. And yes, we've removed the beef, but the mushrooms.
There was nothing wrong with what he did there. There was no clickbaity title, unfortunately. And you're not going to be watching my video rooting against him here. Jamie Oliver, like I said at the beginning, is great when he stays in his wheelhouse and doesn't try to put his influence on ethnic dishes outside of his background. So if you came here expecting me to poo-poo all over him today, then no, that was a very good basic dish for a entry level, somebody just starting to learn how to cook at home. That is exactly the kind of stuff that they should be making. I wish I had something controversial to say. I wish I could make a clickbaity title. I mean, maybe I can, I'm not sure. I hope you enjoyed this, and you know, maybe go out, watch Jamie's video, give it a try. Until next week, I've been Chef James, and thanks for coming down to my bar location in my basement where I shoot these.